High school is a pivotal moment for many students, and the skills they obtain and the choices they make can have substantial long-term consequences. What resources are available to help them? While much attention has been paid to the role teachers play in shaping students' outcomes, another set of adults has received relatively little attention: counselors. High school counselors help students navigate their education and labor market decisions, and U.S. public schools spend billions of dollars a year on them. Like teachers, they can influence students' academic achievement and educational attainment in high school by advising them on what courses to take or dealing with disciplinary actions, but their responsibilities also encompass broader areas, such as providing college and career advice, or directly influencing access to educational opportunities by helping with college applications and providing SAT fee waivers. Yet, while a huge volume of research has studied the role of teachers, counselors have been largely neglected. This paper fills that gap and provides quantitative evidence on the causal effects of individual high school counselors. The author uses student-level data from Massachusetts and exploits the fact that in many of the state's public high schools, students are assigned to counselors based on the first letter or two of their last name. This typically involves sorting students in a given cohort by their last name, then dividing them evenly between the school's N counselors. In this example, students in the graduating class of 2009 are split evenly across four counselors, giving rise to the following assignments. Students in other cohorts are also assigned to the same four counselors, but because the distribution of last names and the number of students vary across cohorts, the assignment cutoffs also vary across cohorts. The author uses this quasi-random variation to estimate counselor value added. This is a measure of each counselor's effectiveness that is based on actual outcomes achieved by students they supervise. To estimate value added, she compares the outcomes of similar students who attend the same school, but who are assigned different counselors because of their last name and/or cohort. In a given school and for a given cohort, counselor value added is derived from student outcomes in other cohorts, then causal effects are estimated from the relationship between counselor value added and student outcomes in this cohort. As a validity check, these figures show there is no relationship between counselor value added and students' predicted outcomes based on their 7th grade test scores. This alleviates concerns that despite the quasi-random assignment rules, students might be systematically sorted across different counselors according to unobservable characteristics. So, does being assigned to a more effective counselor matter? The answer is unequivocally yes. Students assigned to higher value-added counselors have better outcomes. Those assigned to a counselor who is one standard deviation above average are 2 percentage points more likely to graduate high school and attend college, 1.7 percentage points more likely to persist between a first and second year of college, and 1.2 percentage points more likely to earn a bachelor's degree. Higher value-added counselors also affect other aspects of students' high school and college careers, including having a positive impact on test scores and GPA, and increasing the probability of attending a selective college. Reassuringly, counselor value added is only a significant predictor of student outcomes for those whose last names actually fall within their assignment range, and not for students who fall just before or after the letter cutoff. Counselor effects are also largest for low-achieving students. While a 1 standard deviation improvement in counselor value added is associated with a 3.2 percentage point increase in high school graduation rates and a 2.5 percentage point increase in college attendance for low-achieving students, the analogous numbers for high-achieving students are only 0.8 and 1.6 percentage points, respectively. Counselors also matter more for low-income students' high school graduation. These patterns suggest that counselors may be an important resource for closing socioeconomic gaps in education. This figure explores which aspects of a counselor's role are most important by showing how different dimensions of counselor effectiveness are related to 4 key elements of students' educational attainment. Effectiveness in terms of college readiness and college selectivity is the most predictive of whether students graduate high school and attend college, which indicates that a key channel through which counselors increase students' educational attainment is by providing information about post-secondary education opportunities and directly lowering the barriers to accessing them. Given the substantial benefits, how do we increase student access to effective counseling? One approach may be to reduce counselor caseloads. Many counselors in the U.S. have caseloads well above the 250 students recommended by the American School Counselor Association. Another, more impactful option may be to improve counselor effectiveness itself. But in this paper's data, it is difficult to predict which counselors are effective based on their observable characteristics. There is some evidence that matching students and counselors on race can be beneficial, but more research is needed to determine how to identify effective counselors or improve effectiveness through training. Finally, it is worth emphasizing that when it comes to students' high school completion and college outcomes, the estimated benefits of effective counseling are similar in magnitude to the estimated benefits of effective teaching. This suggests that while extensive resources are currently devoted to improving teaching, more research and policy attention should be paid to improving access to effective counselors. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on counseling in other settings, as well as work on the determinants of educational attainment and the role of personalized guidance in particular.